Alyshia here from SciTech, and welcome to Toy Teardown. This is the video series where we have a look at toys that you know and love, and we pull them apart, and we try and use some science to explain how they work. We're here at SciTech on beautiful Wajak Noongar Boodja, and today we're going to have a look at motors. So motors have been around since the 1800s, with the very first motor having been made to make an elevator go up and down. Since then, motors have completely transformed our lives. They're used in motor cars. Like this little guy, who's about to fall off the edge of the table. The motors in this car turn the wheels round and round. So, our robot vehicle over here has two motors, one on each wheel. It makes the wheels turn. So, I've got one of those motors here. Let's have a look. So, got a wheel. We're going to attach that here onto what's called the axle. There we go. And I got a battery pack. What's going to happen when we attach the wires? And I put these two together instead. Whoops. Using my fine motor skills. There we go. And we're going forward and doing donuts all around the place. So that's kind of the basics of how the motor works. Well, let's look inside. All right, here's our motor. So we got two wires that come off. One's going to be a positive and the other's going to be a negative. And if we have a look over this side, we've got a bit of a metal bit here and this plastic casing that goes around it. This white bit sticks out and that's where the wheel goes. So we've got a couple of screws here. I'm going to pull those off and pull this apart and have a look at what's inside. Just a heads up, as usual on Toy Teardown, if you are going to be pulling apart your toys, make sure your adults at home know that you're doing it, because you don't want to ruin your toys and not be able to fix them. I always try and be a bit careful with these when I'm using screwdrivers in motors, because there can be all sorts of things inside that can fall out. Is it the right size screwdriver? Do I have another screwdriver? I'll just try a little bit more force. There we go. Okay, so now that we've put out the screws, we're just going to try and open this up nice and carefully.
Nice and carefully.
There we go. So, we put this all back together. What we have is this thing which spins. This then spins these gears here. So it turns out this plastic casing here is really just to hold the rest of these gears. And all these gears do is they turn this spinning motion into a spinning motion this way. So this spins the gears in which makes a spinning motion on a different angle. But we don't really need these for it to be a motor. It's already a motor as is. So if I connect it like this, I'm going to pull this bit off and I'm going to attach one of these. It's spinning a little bit easier. There you go. So this is the kind of spinning motion that made our drone fly and creates an upward movement. But this wouldn't be a Toy Teardown episode if we didn't go even further. So I'm going to try and pull this thing apart. It looks kind of tricky. It's got lots of metal parts. I'm not sure that I have the right tools, but we're going to give it a go. So it looks pretty well connected. It's got this really, really kind of sturdy plastic and metal. I only have some pretty basic tools here, but I'm going to try. So these are just the cables here. Oh yes, there we go. Ha ha. Ah, awesome, okay. So what you can see here is, fantastic. I'm gonna pull this out. So this here is metal casing that surrounds the motor. You've got one, two, three, four of these metal plates that are surrounding some copper wiring underneath. This casing here is really important. As you can see, there's two of these things here. And what those things are is really important. They are magnets. So it's not going to be easy for me to show you how these magnets actually work. So I'm going to get some other magnets. We're going to try and see if we can work out how this spins around. All right, so I've got some magnets here to try and show you what's happening to our little axle here of our motor. Magnets are really, really important in the movement of our motors. So I've got a compass here, which points to north because it's attracted to our Earth's magnetic field. So essentially, the little magnet in here is sensitive enough to pick up Earth's magnetic field, but magnets have north and south poles. If we put some magnets around it, it'll start to go haywire. If I switch the polarity of these magnets, what happens? The magnet starts spinning around. See, the spinning of the magnet inside is basically what this is going to be doing inside our motor. So, inside this, these two magnets are changing polarity and causing this to spin, which is pretty cool. But there's an important difference here between just any magnet and the kind of motor, the kind of magnet inside our motors. These magnets can actually be switched off and on, unlike these ones. So magnets are actually naturally occurring. So in the Earth, there's all sorts of minerals and metals, which if they have magnetite in them, they're magnetic. But inside our motors, they're actually not naturally magnetic. They have to be made magnetic. It's called an electromagnet. So they're only magnetic when there's an electrical current going through them. Otherwise, it would constantly be spinning, which is why we can actually switch off a motor. Pretty cool. So it turns out that the spinning motion inside a motor is caused by magnets, but not just any magnets, electromagnets. You can actually make an electromagnet yourself at home, but we're not going to go through that today because I want to keep thinking about motors and maybe how we might be able to change some of the motors we've seen today, maybe make them bigger or faster. Let's see if we can add some more power and see what happens. Remember what happened when we had 4 AA batteries? I wonder what would happen if we used a bigger battery. Like this big battery. It's probably worth saying at this point, it's not a great idea to take massive batteries and attach them to your various things at home just because you could burn it out. But we're at SciTech and we're trained, so we're gonna try it out here. Now, it might be a little bit tricky to see in this video, but do you notice how much faster the motor with the big battery spins? Various toys, obviously, or appliances and things need different amounts of power. Hair dryers probably need a lot more power than what a battery can give you, so that's why they plug into the wall. So the more powerful the battery, the faster and more powerful the motor. So yes, there are motors all around the place. You can see them in fans, in car motors. So make sure you have a think about some of the DC motors around you. Maybe you can pull something apart and turn it into something else, which is one of my favorite things to do. But until next time, I hope you really enjoyed the show. I certainly had heaps of fun pulling apart DC motors today. If you love the show, make sure you subscribe, like, and give us some examples maybe of DC motors that you've seen at home in the comments. This has been Toy Teardown. Thank you so much for tuning in. We'll see you next time. Bye. Since then, motors have completely transformed our lives, being used in motor vehicles.